Hi all. Now you know that we implement GUI related programs or GUI applications using Java. So in this particular video we will see GUI programming using swings. Now in earlier days we used to use AWT, which is Abstract Windows Toolkit, for GUI related programming, but nowadays we use Swing for that. Now what is GUI? GUI is termed as graphical user interface. So it is user friendly. That means, suppose if you compare Unix operating system and Windows operating system, Windows operating system is more popular as far as personal computers are concerned, since it has some GUI. There are some icons, some buttons or menus onto the screen, and what we need to do is only double click or single click or drag the things. So this is more user friendly. Now in swings we have different components which will represent the element onto the screen. Like, these are the components which are available in swings. Z button is there. Z button means it will represent a button, OK button, cancel button. Z text field is there. If I am entering the name, like if you open some online form, after name you write your name, so that area in which you write is a text field. The combo box is there. If multiple action multiple options are there and I want to select particular option, then I will use combo box. The list is there, again it's similar to the combo box. That means multiple elements are there, but I can select more than one element. In combo box I can select single element. Checkbox is there. Radio button is there. If yes, no are the options, I will choose either one. So that is radio button. The password field, if I put password, it should not be displayed. So that is done by the password field component. Now when I create a user interface, I first create UI part, like GUI. So when I create UI, I need to put these components, Z button, Z text area, text field, whatever is there, onto the UI. So the format in which I can put them is defined by the layout. So in Java there are three layouts: flow layout, border layout and grid layout. So flow layout means one component is placed after the other component in sequence. In border layout, the UI is divided into five different parts. The five parts are center, north, south, east, west. So I will mention on which part I want to place my component. So that is done in border layout. And in grid layout, the UI is divided into few rows and columns, and I will put my component, and when I add that component, I will mention the row number and column number. Now after creation of UI, next part is handling an event. Now event means, suppose I click on the button or if I drag the mouse, that is treated as an event by the computer. So the whole event handling mechanism or event delegation model is described in this slide. So there will be some components onto the UI which will take the user's attention, and user will perform some action on them. Say button click. Then after that, system will take the metadata of that component and it will generate one object which is called as event object. Now that object is passed to the particular listener. Now listener is already registered with the given component. So listener will take that object, and the data which is fetched from that is passed to the corresponding handler. Handler will have some method inside that. Like for button click we have action perform method. So that method will take the data, and the method will have business logic regarding what to do after an event is occurred. So this is called as event delegation model. If I talk about the listeners, there are different listeners in Java. Like action listener is there, change listener is there, mouse listener is there. So each listener will invoke depending on the action. Like action listener is called, or action listener will detect if I click on the button. Change listener will detect if I change the size of some component. Suppose I resize the window, then it will be detected by the change listener. Mouse listener, it will listen to the movements of the mouse. Mouse motion is there, mouse motion listener is there. Key listener, window listener. Key listener will detect for key press. Item listener is there, adjustment listener is there, and window focus listener is there. So these listeners are used if I want to implement some application which is Swing application handling the few events. So this was regarding the swings in Java.